Shut up!
I was crazy about Pong's people.
It wasn't breakdancing, but it was very athletic.
These girls could move. They were wonderful.
Well, they're very sexy as well.
Pan is the god of dance and music and debauchery and dance, all those lovely things. You can understand why Dad's liked it, but Mum didn't object.
Some were very risque for their time, and some were very risque when I look back on it for these times.
I think 1974 was the moment when we kind of realised that how famous we were.
Pans people!
Pans people!
Pans people!
We had wonderful costumes.
I remember one costume particularly, which was a black dress. Sequins. I've always loved sequins and sparkles.
We did like it when we felt glamorous. You know, we went often in costumes that we really felt glamorous.
When will I see you?
We did that particular number on the show, but what happened was, later on, we were asked to appear on Jimmy Savile's Clunk Click show.
Dear friends, Pans people, how about that? Here they are.
These dresses, they were slit right up to sort of our crutches.
I shall do the rest of this interview with my hands over my eyes, like this, and I shall be talking to these young ladies about their attributes.
You shouldn't sit down in them. It was a bad choice.
Louise. Now then, apart from having to sit very still, just now.
Yes.
Excuse me.
Trying very hard, actually.
We had toupee tape keeping us stuck all the way down the side to keep us in, because otherwise everything would have fallen out.
I did ask these young ladies if they would come in, that we could see something of them, i.e. like to see the legs, because they wanted to come demurely dressed with all little sleeves down here and things like that, and I said no, because there's lots of gentlemen in hospitals and all sorts of places, and they... You know what I mean? They want to see him.
Mary Whitehouse, who was the campaigner against, you know, filth on television, she went completely ballistic. I think she had an apoplexy. She was so outraged. She said, how dare we wear these dresses? You know, when it was a children's program. But we, there's nothing wrong with it. I mean, not as if it fell out. We just looked gorgeous.
Let's face the music and dance.
In 1974, we were... at our height, I suppose. We did our own concert, which was, I think, the pinnacle of our career.
Dancer's dream come true. Louise and Dee Dee did a very raunchy little number.
All we did was kneel on these cushions and gyrate, just move this part of the body very slowly. And it was a very sexy number and very pretty. We wore... almost next to nothing. We had sort of like just sort of suction pads here and a tiny bikini, all embroidered, very beautiful, most expensive costume we ever wore.
We all wanted to do that. Why couldn't I be chosen for that?
I don't think every number worked as we perhaps had hoped.
There are smiles that make us happy.
Sang, oh my goodness.
Dancers, you know, should be seen and not heard.
And it was, well, I thought we were awful. Oh dear.
All together now.
Shut up!
A girl group on television every week of the year. And of course the feminists went mad. They didn't like that at all. I have never felt exploited, dancing on Top of the Pops, being with the stars. I mean, what young girl wouldn't want to do that?
For one all too brief period, incredibly brief period, I went out with one of them.
Did you ever go out with Martin Shaw?
No.
Martin Shaw? I wish, dear. He's gorgeous. No, I didn't.
Which one did you go out with?
I'm not telling you.
Oh, well, I better own up then, hadn't I?